what's happened? This one video was just about these charities, because obviously a lot of people messaging about these charities. Yeah, the scams. Most of them. The scams. What I mean by that is that what these charities do, as I've already said in previous videos, you're taking 90% of whatever you donate. Now we're going to be exposing them when we get to Africa. Right? And what I mean by that is everything these charities are saying that they've done, we're going to show they haven't. Think about it like this. Do you remember these shoe boxes they used to make in school, and they used to fill them up and send them to Africa? None of the people I met in the slums ever received them. Again, that's just a scam. But on a second thing, when you look at it and you think hundreds if not billions of pounds has been raised, why has nothing changed in Africa, right? Why is it not, like, why are these people still living in poverty? And when I say poverty, I'm talking bare minimum. I'll tell you why. Because when the British charities and other charities across the world, right, say for example you raise 100 million, by law, they only need to donate 10%, so 10 million quid. You can keep the other 90% for what they call admin fees. And then what happens then? By the time the 10 million goes over to, say, let's say Sierra Leone, right, the African government, the Sierra Leone government, they'll probably take 9 million quid of that 90% again. And then by the time it falls down to people in the slums, all they receive is a bag full of food each, right, which they're grateful for because they're starving. But they don't actually realise that hundreds of millions of pounds are being raised for them. They're just happy with the food. And this is where the charity scam comes into it, because no one's actually exposing this, no one's actually speaking about it, no one's actually doing anything about it. That's what my social media is about, right? I'm building my following purely for when I go to Africa and we start exposing this, these charities. Now, as I said, I could have done these podcasts months ago. If that's all I was bothered about, views and fucking followers, I would have done them months ago, knowing full well my followers would have tripled. I haven't done them purely because, as I said, I want to get to Africa first. I'm going to do the podcast just before I go to Africa. So then when you land, when you broadcast, I'll actually be in Africa. And that means that the people in the slums will get maximum exposure. And that's what it's about for me. They're my priority. Yeah, but these charities are going to be getting exposed on, because it's on a different level. And that's purely what it's about, because social media has got so much power in terms of exposing people, like especially like these charities. And that's what we're going to be doing. Yeah, and as I said, we're going to be starting off at this school with these kids with cataracts. That's the main thing. I'm hoping to get over there next month. Hopefully. We'll see how it fucking goes. Yeah, but one second. What's happening, lad? Yeah, one sec. Yeah, so what we're going to do, we're going to be exposing these fucking little rats. All these fucking charity bosses, right, who are robbing hundreds of millions of pounds, paying themselves in hundreds of thousand pound bonuses every single month. That's a scam. That's a blatant fucking scam. So yeah, as I said, stay tuned for that. And we'll be fucking exposing these charities in a bit.